Oh my gosh. After living in the jungle for 3 months, her clarity became crystal clear on where she was headed, on her success, and how to untangle her brain. Oh my gosh. Many of you are aware that you need to stand out in today's sea of online coaches, right? Some of you don't have a clue how to begin to stand out. Most of you just need to have some clarity and solid resources, as well as a place to jump from. My guest today is fluent, let me get that out there, in three languages. I can barely talk one. She is a writer, a public speaker, a TEDx organizer and participant, and calls herself a strategist and a coach. She helps her clients clarify their idea worth sharing. She designs their communication strategies and implements business growth systems for her clients. They become speakers, authors, and they take their message to larger audiences like TEDx and beyond. This lady has taken over hundreds of people through her process and gotten them on stages for TEDx talks. It won't take you long to figure out why she gets to be on the Erin Strayer Show today. And I can't wait for you to hear what she's going to talk about. If you are watching from any other platform other than the Erin Strayer Show, thank you so much. There's a link right above you in the feed. Go ahead and click that. Come on over to our platform here. We will be able to see you and see your comments, answer your questions when you're over here on our platform, but we really appreciate you. We are live on the Erin Strayer Show, where we are all about promoting, cultivating, and expanding amazing female entrepreneurs that are out there in the world doing things just a little bit differently. We talk about hot topics like becoming clear on your message, oh my gosh, right? And getting on stages and pain points and all kinds of things like that. We also give you workarounds to the challenges that we face daily. And so many of us want to check that box next to a TED Talk. So who am I? I'm Erin Strayer, and I'm your host. And recovering corporates and entrepreneurs hire me to get them business beyond the basics, because most of them are indecisive, they're held hostage by their own fear, and have settled for average. So I help them keep on task by setting obtainable goals, plugging gaping holes in their business and personal lives, and taking their dreams to reality. And bottom line, I provide executive level accountability sessions so that you and your business gets the attention to detail it deserves. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait for you to meet Miss Dolores Hirschmann, and the crowd goes wild. Hello, friend.
Hello, thank you for having me. I was already chatting on your live stream. So
you're happy over there chatting it up. That's awesome. Hi. Oh, Cindy's here. Hi, Cindy. Yeah. She's fabulous. Yeah. She's fabulous. It's nice to have the people over here. And when we can see them commenting, it's always so much fun. So, like, seriously, you spending 3 months in the jungle was one of the things that just massively stood out when you and I chatted before about being on the show. And I'm like, are you kidding me? Are you absolutely kidding me? Like, what is going on? And what was the decision? Like, I want to kind of bring the people, like, from then to here. From there to here.
Well, so personally, the decision of going to the jungle, there was a couple of layers, right? Whenever we make a decision, there's a couple of moments and instances when you realize, oh, that was another reason why I did it, right? But originally, I was at this presentation with my then boyfriend, and this person was sharing their experience doing community work in Siberia. Now, this is an Argentinian young woman, that's who I was, in Buenos Aires watching this presentation. And I remember saying out loud, saying, oh, that would be so cool to do like a adventure to a foreign place and just, you know, test your boundaries. And I remember the guy was like, you would never survive, he said to me. And that was a big seed.
And you're like, was that a challenge?
Watch me. Nothing like someone saying to you, you can't do it, for you to want to do it, right? So that really was a beginning of a seed. But I had this kind of romantic idea of what would it look like to put myself in a situation where I was like, I had to come out of my shell. I had to like become maybe the heroine or just overcome something. Mm-hmm. Now, granted, I was 24 years old. I had overcome a very difficult childhood with divorced parents. I had overcome, and I don't think I shared this with you, but I had overcome pancreatic tumor where I was supposed to die and I didn't die. And I think I forgot that detail.
Yeah, you forgot that one.
So when I was 20, I was told I was going to die. And my brother sent me a letter saying how much he loved me. And when I read his letter, I said, oh, I'm really going to die. Because your brother never writes that letter, right? So anyway, I had survived that. So why did I need to go to a jungle? So I don't know why. Obviously, I was looking for an adventure. And I was looking for that place of expansion. And there was not, I'm going to be honest, Erin, there was not a lot of thinking involved. My gut said, go, and I went. Mm. And 2 weeks into it, I found myself living in the jungle in a hammock between two trees and asking myself, what was I thinking?
What in the world? That's a little behind the game there, because you're already hanging between two trees.
A little delayed thought process.
Little delayed on the...
on the thinking part.
However, what happened in the hammock, right? Like, what happened in that moment, 2 weeks into your jungle experience,
hanging between a couple of trees, the only Argentinian in a group of British, you know, British group. So I would say, hey, you RG, we sank your ships in the Falkland War. So it was kind of tough. Yeah. But what happened was that I was really miserable. I was truly miserable. I was crying. I was like, I had an ear infection. I was miserable. And the organizers came up to me and said, you know, you do not have to stay. Like, you can go. Like, you're not hostage here. You can, you know, change your ticket, go home. And it was, again, it was that kind of feeling that someone thought I couldn't make it. Mm-hmm. Kind of second time, right? For me to simply say, I have it in me. I just have to find that place in me and bring that out to play. And I made that decision that I was going to finish what I started. There was just no way I wouldn't. And so I got my second wind. Honestly, I got my second wind. And honestly, I'm going to make a parallel here because I see this a lot in my clients. Many times my clients come to me having tried kind of everything.
Sure.
And just about to give up. And in many ways, clarity can become a second wind. You know, the clarity of intention, the clarity of why you are doing this, or the clarity of how you help people and communicating that efficiently can become a second wind. So anyway, for me in the jungle that day, having the choice to leave opened up for me the choice to stay in an intentional way.
Isn't that cool? Like that's how you flip that. Right? Like the choice to leave is the choice to stay. And like, seriously, how many of us hit that? This is too hard. I don't feel good. It's making me sick, right? Like you got the ear infections going on. You clearly are past the, I don't really dig the jungle. I don't have running water.
The romantic idea is gone.
Yeah. Right. And now there's physical manifestations from being out there, right? And you've hit the wall, but you've chosen to either, you know, do you stay or do you go? They wrote a song about it, right? Like, we'll sing here in a moment.
But you can say shit or get off the pot.
Right, right. Like, there's so many. Like, I'd love our friends to drop their comments in here for their take on, do you stay or do you go? Do you shit or do you get off the pot? Do you, right? Like, what choice do you take? And what's the clarity that comes when you've made that decision, right? Like, because that's what happened for you, right? There was massive clarity in the moment that you were offered a choice.
Yes. And so I think, and entrepreneurs, how many entrepreneurs buy into the romantic idea?
Right.
And prefer the romantic idea of the jungle, right? Oh, I can manage my own time. I can make as much money as I want. Mm-hmm. I can choose who to work with and who to not work with. And all this, they're not myths, but they can be myths. It's not all that. And so how many people do we know that come into the entrepreneurship jungle only to find out that the only way you're going to make it through this jungle, not that it's a jungle, it can turn into a paradise, but the only way you can make it through is to understand who you are, what drives you, and what is the gift of saying yes to the challenge. For me, I knew that if I said yes to that jungle that day, and I didn't know the details, but I felt that if I finished what I had started, I would be a different Dolores at the end. I would have a confidence and a strength that probably was what I was looking for.
Yeah. So fast forward to now, because that was
many years ago. I'm not going to say how many.
Right. Last year. not. But right, like fast forward, and how has that experience brought you and still is so prominent in what you do and how you relate in your, because you're a clarity coach, right? Not only are you a strategist and you do all these amazing business things, but you're specifically like a clarity coach, right? Like how clearly that's a massive, still massively plays front and center for you.
So for me, I mean, I love metaphors. Metaphors is a big part of how I communicate and how I help people communicate. Yeah. Because I feel that the more we can have our audiences anchor our concepts and our ideas and our thoughts into visual representations of what that looks like, the more we can get them to really engage in what we're saying. And so, you know, the jungle has become a metaphor for me. And I think what it is in the work that I do for clarity is it's about unpacking what you're feeling at any point in your life and allowing some light to come into this kind of mess of fear, mess of overwhelm, mess of thoughts, mess of ideas, whatever that may be. It's always the same. It's just collapsed concepts or collapsed emotions. Mm-hmm. When you start kind of bringing that collapsed ball of things, you spread it out and you start bringing some light, and you bring light through curiosity. You bring light through gentleness, through allowing what there is, through awareness, right? Once you start doing that exercise, you really can start, for no lack of a better word, discerning what really is there and what are the choices.
Yeah.
And when you start understanding what are the forks in that road and where are the directions you can go, then you can engage action. But we typically are trying to take action on an unpacked mess in our heads. And we flop.
Yep. How many have done that? Right? like there's so much, and we're in the jungle. Like I love that metaphor, and for you it's real, but for me, I've never been in the jungle, but I have been in thick underbrush. thick underbrush, my friend. And right, like you just like my machete won't cut it, and I can't, there's not a clear path, and there's the stick burrs are all over, and the, you know, right? Like all of the things that get in our way in that metaphor, if we will, right? Like it's really something when you can't even see a glimpse of light coming through that underbrush. It's scary. It's like, you don't know your way out, right? Like I'm talking to the choir.
Yeah, I mean it's just and so there's a I believe that action brings clarity and clarity brings action. They're like a little bit of the chicken and the egg. But when we are in that place where we are overwhelmed by the feeling of that underbrush or the jungle or that overwhelm or stuckness, there is a moment of leaning back and allow what there is and what you feel and honor that, right?
Sure.
because if we push it out, it's not going to help us. And then start to discern, okay, what are my choices? Again, it's all about clarifying the path so you can choose one.
I love that. And I just want to point out, Tiffany's on with us. We have a lot of people watching on our watch party too, but Tiffany says no jungle here. She's a city girl. Yeah, but you can.
Oh, sister, that is a bigger jungle. Trust me. At least the jungle I lived in, I could shower under the rain or drink that water. I don't think you can even drink that water in the city.
I know, right? And you don't have to deal with the traffic and the mean people and the whatever, but yeah, right. It's,
the monkeys are nice.
The monkeys are nice. Right. But it's a total different, yes, it's a different kind of jungle. You got the city jungle, you got the serious jungle, and, they're the same to me. You still got to navigate it. You still got to figure out your way through. You still got to find a parking spot.
Yep.
And get to work on time, right? Like you still, like all of the things still have to happen. And so going forward from there, standing out from the competition now, right? Like clarity coaching, how did that all?
So for me, my background is business and communications. I went to business school in Argentina. I actually, my graduating thesis in 1996, I don't know if I mentioned this to you when we spoke, but my graduating thesis in 1996 was marketing on the internet, relationship marketing.
Oh, cool.
It was the first paper in the world in Spanish of what the heck to do with the internet and how it was going to completely change, how we market our products and services. But, so fast forward to today. You know, I went from being an entrepreneur. I launched a clothing company. I launched a software company. I launched an after-school program as I was having my children. I have four children, another uncle, each one of them. But it was when I became a consultant for startup companies or for projects within big companies that I realized I could talk strategy until people were blue in their face. I couldn't make them do it. Mm-hmm. And that's when I went back to school for coaching. And I kind of added to my skill set the behavior, the human behavior side of the things that we do, specifically in business and in innovation and in marketing and communications. And then one layer that I added to that was that I started playing with the concept of communication from the TED framework of And because, as my mom said, when I launched my language school, my mom was like, couldn't you have just hired a tutor for your children? You had to go and get six teachers, 150 kids, and a whole school going. So I could have attended a couple of TEDx events and watched some TED Talks online. But no, I had to go and organize an event with 1,200 people and whatever. So anyway, that's just how I live my life.
Right. But go big or go home.
I'll go home. Yeah. In doing so, I realized in organizing the TEDx and kind of volunteering my time for that project, I learned something about myself. And it was that a lot of visionaries and authors, even if they've written a book, and even speakers, really have a hard time communicating clearly. It is so much easier to give a 60 or 90 minute presentation than to hit a chord in under 18 minutes.
Mm.
And so it almost kind of was serendipity that it all came about to understand that the kind of coach that I am and the kind of unique brilliance, if you want, that I have is exactly what I used in the jungle, what I've used all my life, is unpacking what there is and organizing it in a way that someone can either communicate it or you can make decisions or you can take action.
Yeah.
So how did I become a clarity call? Because a coach and doing clarity calls, because I just am attracted to people's confusion.
Isn't that, you know, and you're like, let me help you with that. Let me like sort through the laundry.
Yeah, I mean, literally, I love it. I mean, probably like the same way you love, you know, project managing and helping people stay on track. You know, there's you're attracted to that. You don't get tired of doing that. Yeah. That's how I feel about clarity.
Yeah. So currently, like, you're a clarity coach. You specialize in getting your business strategy clients like ridiculously clear. But the other part of you is within doing that, you also have coaching that you do for TED Talk people. And like, there's a difference between doing a TED Talk and really standing out in the crowd.
So here's what the beauty there. So the whole thing about helping someone speak on a TEDx stage or even get selected for TEDx stage, again, came about someone asking me, would you help me with this? And I said, I don't do that. And yeah. this was like 4 years ago. And this person's like, but you could try. I'll pay you whatever you ask me. Can you just try to help me? I mean, you know the insides of the process. And so I did, and it was very successful. And I realized how much I loved, you know, the helping someone clarify their message so that they can deliver it in that platform, but also stand out in the application process.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so that standing out actually now has translated into helping my clients, which are service entrepreneurs, stand out in whatever space they are. So whether you're trying to stand out from hundreds of applications applying to speak on a TEDx, or wanting to stand out from hundreds of applications speaking at a conference or on a social media post or from other competitors, the process is the same. Is you must clearly communicate your differentiator and your unique value proposition.
Mm, that UVP. Gotta get it right.
Gotta get it right. And gotta... So I believe in inspiring my market to work with me, not pushing it, not selling. I don't teach sales funnels. I teach trust funnels. It's something I came up with.
I love that.
I teach the systematic process of building trust-based relationships. And the sell is a simple consequence of the trust funnel being properly implemented.
Yeah. And it's so, there's so many people commenting on we're on a watch party right now too. And they're like, they're loving it. They're loving it. Eileen is on there. She said makes a big difference when we can learn how our benefits affect everything we do.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And she said she also struggled for years until she became very clear on her message and who she serves.
Yeah. And then everything changes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, the moment we are really, the moment we pick a lane,
right,
we end up going faster because we're not going like this in the highway.
Right, right. You're not weaving in and out, right?
Like you're less likely to crash if you're on a lane.
Just having come back from spring break, like my husband's like, there's another derelict weaving in and out. Like he had all kinds of names for those people. And it's funny that reference was just made because that happens so much. Oh, I'm going to follow them because clearly whatever they're doing is working and I'm going to do that.
I saw that. Yeah. Vanilla. You become a nobody.
Vanilla. Tan.
Yeah.
The
truth is the whole concept of clarity coach. I have a client who calls me the clarity queen. It was given to me by my clients.
Yeah.
It really was. I mean, clarity is what I do, and where I place it is on speaking strategies, specifically TEDx, on leveraged business models, and on consistent business strategies.
Yeah. See, and that's huge. That's so huge. And I know I want to we could clearly go way over time, but I really want to honor you and your time. And I want to hop into how people find you, what you got going on. I really want to fine tune that. Are you full in Hawaii yet?
Oh yeah. We have some space in Hawaii. So
this is hot stuff, people.
Yeah. So here's where So you can find me at mastersinclarity.com. You can go to mastersinclarity.com/free And you can download two books I'll recommend. One is How to Stand Out Using the TED Strategies. And the other book is How to Engage Your Audience in Under 18 Minutes. We didn't talk about this earlier, but I have a full agency now that we run under Masters in Clarity, because our clients come, they get clear, and then they go out and find vendors and they get unclear over there, and they never get their job done, whether it's a website or books or whatever it is that they're trying to do. So now Masters in Clarity, we do ghostwriting of marketing books. We do full websites. We do concierge research and pitching for speaking engagements.
Wow.
So we literally research and pitch on your behalf. You get assigned a visibility manager. And we are consistently out there for you. So we have all kinds of services. But one of the things that I'm doing a lot in 2019 is really strategic partnerships. And we, with Danielle Fitzpatrick Clark, I have a partnership where we are hosting a two-day Kauai-based event where people will walk away with their talk already done and written, ready to pitch, the video done and scripted so that they can apply to events, specifically TEDx, and there's some amazing bonus in that program as well. I know we only have room for 20. I'm not sure how many spaces we have left. The dates for those are we moved it because my calendar got too full. So we moved it to September.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Now I'm getting more excited.
Yeah, we moved it because I have my daughter graduating and we were just too.
Your calendars were too full.
What?
Your calendars were too full.
Her calendar, my calendar was full. So we are doing this on, I'll tell you right now, on September 12th and 13th in Hawaii.
And it's called?
TEDx Workshop, xworkshop.com. You can go to xworkshop.com. And you can learn more about that. So yes, we have, and we're taking deposits. Actually, there's a big thing going on that. So one of the things we're doing is we are taking deposits until June 9th because Danielle has a live event. And xworkshop.info. We're taking deposits of, I think it's $500 deposit, because on June 9th, we're going to do a drawing. And if you have given your deposit, one of the people who've given the deposit will go in for free. They don't have to pay the remaining balance.
What?
We're giving one spot for free. You put $500 and then you don't have to pay the rest of the workshop investment.
Serious big stuff. Okay, so throw some stats at the people, like pump yourself up a little bit. Hundreds of people you have coached.
Yes.
In this TEDx way to stand out.
Yes. And I've coached large corporations on this framework. Right now I have four clients working with it right now who are selected as keynote speakers at conferences, and they're all asking for under 20-minute TED-like talks. So whether TEDx is your place or not, all events are asking for this style of speaking because it's more effective. There's research that shows that people have a maximum capacity of retaining attention for 20 minutes or less. Mm-hmm. TEDx does it that way.
Yep. And what are those? Those are like
18 minutes, and you deliver your talk in 18 minutes. Yeah.
Yep. So I want you to brag on yourself just a little bit.
Okay.
How many of your clients ballpark have hit the TEDx stage?
because all of our private, the people that work with me privately, we actually stay with them until they get selected. Mm-hmm. So 9 months, they get selected. All of them.
And I heard that you have 100% qualification. yes. of your students.
Yes.
Yes. So it's not just, I know we're like right at our time, but I really wanted to bring this home. So you work with your people until they have been accepted and qualified.
Yeah. To present. And they hit the stage.
Like, and they hit the stage.
All the way to what do I wear?
Right. Right. Yeah. And yeah. I think that's so like beneficial to bring forward for people because, I want to point out that you didn't bring it up. I brought it up as far as your stats and putting people forward. And I obtained those numbers from one of your partners.
Oh, really?
I did. Because I did my research. I know. Because I want people to know that even in our pre-interview, you didn't brag about your success. Mm. And I think that's huge because your whole focus is the end result, whatever that takes, whatever that time allotment is, whatever that looks like. And I think, oh, Tiffany said TEDx is on her list.
Go ahead and mastersincarry.com/free, download the 18-minute book. You'll learn everything about it.
So grab that 18-minute book on that free. I'll put that back up on the screen right here. So seriously, people, sorry, my nose is running. If the TED Talks are in your future, because really everybody that watches us and is on our other platforms right now, I know all of their hands are raised, that either is on their list, it's on their vision board, it's on their, whatever you want to call that dream board that's on your wall of your office, a TED Talk is on there. And to be able to coach with somebody that not only has been on the stage, that has done the work, that is a clarity coach and a business strategist, like you have all the pieces to the puzzle and your corners are solid. I just want to say that. Like I love putting people like you in front of my audience. I love putting people like you that are so solid in what you do and you have a niche and a stream and are successful in that. And not only that, you have the extent of the support behind it with all of the main stage of mastersinclarity.com, right? Like all the pieces to the inside of that puzzle, not just the border in the corners, yeah. Right? Like it's tight and it's there and it's massive and it's so worth your time and your money and your energy, period, to hang out with this lady.
So am I hanging out with you in Hawaii in September?
Let me just tell you, September works a whole lot better than June.
Yeah. It's for most people, including Danielle and I. So
I know.
But there's nothing to lose. Get into the drawing. Just get your deposit into the drawing and you might even go for free.
Well, am I seeing you this week? Or am I just seeing Dolores this week?
Danielle, you mean?
Danielle, sorry. Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. You might. I haven't looked at the calendar yet, but I might. If I'm not, I might hop on.
Oh, so cool. So cool. Yeah, so cool. So you guys, seriously, we've been hanging out with the amazing Dolores Hirschmann. She runs a company called mastersinclarity.com. Please, please, please hang out with her in your space. If you have even so much as thought about getting clearer in your own business, maybe TEDx is 2 to 3 years down the road for you. Maybe it's not even on your vision board, but getting massively clear in your strategies, in the function of your business, in the mindset of yourself, inside of your business. Dolores is a amazing, 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 strong resource for you to do that. Oh, Australia is on with us. Hi, Roz, coming in. Seems like you came in at the end. You did, but you can grab the replay. It's fantastic, Roz. It'll be worth your time. Thanks for hopping on with us. But we are signing off for today. And Dolores, I adore you. I adore what you're doing. I'm so glad that you're in my circle and that we get to play together going forward. So you guys, seriously, jump on board with the amazing Dolores Hirschmann, mastersinclarity.com. If you guys are part of our showbot that delivers our live people with us, you can go back and click the links and find her there as well. If you're not, just go ahead and drop live in the comments, L-I-V-E. We'll make sure you never miss another show and amazing people that are here live with us on the Erin Strayer Show. So Dolores, you got any parting comments before we head off to forever today?
I will say to everybody, clarity is kindness. And confusion leads to overconsumption. Mm. So if you are finding yourself getting lost inside of your head, just look for clarity. Look for the light.
I'm letting that land, people. And for everybody that's out there, thank you so much for hanging out with us. Let that last moment land from Dolores, and we will see you right back here on the Erin Strayer Show. Take care, everybody.
Bye-bye.